Hello, we are discussing about GATE 2008 ECE paper and this question is related to electronics. A silicon wafer has 100 nanometer of oxide on it and is inserted in a furnace at a temperature above 1000 degree centigrade for further oxidation in dry oxygen. The oxidation rate A is independent of current oxide thickness and temperature. B is independent of current oxide thickness but depends on temperature. C slows down as the oxide grows. D is zero as existing oxide prevents further oxidation. First of all, we should know oxidation is nothing but oxidation is the process of creating SiO2 layer. We are using creating silicon dioxide layer by using silicon and oxygen. There are two methods. Okay, how you are going to get this one? Oxidation is of two types. One is nothing but dry oxidation, or the other is nothing but wet oxidation. Dry oxidation or the other is wet oxidation. Dry oxidation is generally used for formation of thin oxide. It is also called as gate oxide, which is nothing but it is the oxide which resides in between polysilicon gate terminal and channel. Okay, so this is thin oxide, and wet oxidation is going to be used for formation of thick oxide. Thick is nothing but whose thickness is large, or it is also called as field oxide. Okay, so if you are looking at the diagram of, for example, n-channel MOSFET always fabricated under p-type substrate, and these are going to be the source and drain regions of n-plus nature, and in between this place is going to be called as channel. Above that one you will get a silicon dioxide layer, and above that one you will get a polysilicon gate. So this is gate terminal, which is polysilicon, and this is channel region. So the gap between these two things is nothing but this one. Okay, this shaded area is going to be called as, it is very very thin, and this is going to be called as gate oxide or thin oxide. Whereas if you are going for this one, there will be silicon dioxide layer is also present, okay, at these positions. That is, the next nearby transistor is going to be isolated from this transistor. So by that time there is a large width silicon dioxide is used where it is acting as insulator, so that it can isolate the nearby transistor interaction with the present one, so that this is called as thick oxide, or it is also called as field oxide, which is mainly used for the isolation purpose, and whereas gate oxide is nothing but which is used for the MOSFET capacitor action, so that it can act as on as well as off switch. Okay, so for gate oxide we will use the dry oxidation. For thick oxide, that is field oxide, we will use the wet oxidation. First of all, we will see what is the meaning of dry oxidation and what can be the answer for this question. The right option for this question is A. How, we will see now. Okay, dry oxidation first you are going with, because the question is related to this one. Okay, dry oxidation is nothing but it is a process used to get silicon dioxide layer on silicon. Dry oxidation is a process used to get silicon dioxide layer on silicon. How you are going to get this one is nothing but this is chemical reaction. Si plus O2 is equal to SiO2 layer you are going to get. That is, a silicon semiconductor is present. Over that one we are going to be diffusing O2 layers, oxidizing elements. That is nothing but, here it is, oxidizing agents we call. O2 is nothing but oxidizing agents. whenever we diffuse oxidizing agents, that is like O2, and there is an interaction initially placed across silicon and O2, so that initially what you are going to be getting is nothing but a silicon dioxide layer is going to be formed. Okay, let us assume this is a silicon dioxide layer initially formed. This is going to be called as SiO2 layer, whereas it is silicon substrate, and what you are doing is nothing but you are diffusing the oxidizing agents O2. Okay. By that time, first step is nothing but at the interface of silicon itself, the oxidizing agents are reacting, whereas the reaction of oxidizing agents is now at this point to further grow the silicon dioxide. At that time, if it has to grow further, at that time reaction should take place at this point, that is silicon dioxide interface. So this is very important. This is going to be called as silicon dioxide interface, SiO2 interface, because if you want to grow further silicon dioxide, by that time the oxidizing agents has to go and react with the silicon atoms present at silicon dioxide interface. Okay, but in dry oxidation what you are going to get is nothing but very thin oxide. This is thin oxide, and this thin oxide is unable to stop the oxidizing agents, so those oxidizing agents are going to be directly going through the silicon dioxide layer, and they are reacting with the silicon, so that this is going to be increases, SiO2 layer is going to be increases. So this dry oxidation generally performed at a temperature range from the 900 degree centigrade to 1200 degree centigrade. This process is going to be taking place from 900 to 1200 degree centigrade. Meanwhile, the initial silicon dioxide layer on silicon is formed by the reaction of surface of silicon atoms with O2. This is what the first initial process. Okay, and once the silicon dioxide is formed, at that time further oxidation occurs at silicon dioxide interface, that is this is second one, such that oxidizing agents O2 diffuse through the oxide to react with silicon atoms at the interface, so that these oxygen agents are reacting with the silicon atoms at this interface, so that the growth of this silicon dioxide layer is going to be increases. Okay, for thin oxide and gate oxide layers, normally dry oxidation is going to be used. The oxidizing elements can easily diffuse through the initial oxide, and the oxide growth is limited by the reaction rate at the silicon dioxide interface. It is this rate of increase is going to be limited by reaction rate at silicon dioxide interface. So it doesn't depend on the thickness of silicon dioxide layer, because initially the growth oxide is going to be very small only in thickness. So for dry oxidation rate is independent of current oxide thickness and temperature. Okay, but it only depends on reaction rate at silicon dioxide interface, as well as it is linearly varies with time. So if you observe dry oxidation, okay, in dry oxidation oxygen rate is independent of current oxide thickness. It doesn't depend on the current oxide thickness, because the oxidizing agents are directly going through silicon dioxide layer into silicon, and and it is also independent of temperature also, because here the question is given up to about 1000 degree centigrade, the dry oxidation is going to perform from the 900 to 1200 degree centigrade. Whereas if you are observing in case of wet oxidation is nothing but used to get field oxide, okay, that is thick oxide. The oxidation reaction is limited by diffusion of oxidizing elements through the previously formed oxide. In this one, wet oxide is nothing but here the oxidizing elements O2 are going to be limited by this thickness of silicon dioxide layer. Okay, so the diffusion of oxidizing elements are going to be limited by the previously formed oxide in case of wet oxidation, whereas it is not in case of dry oxidation. So for wet oxidation, the oxidation rate slows down as the oxide grows, but in dry oxidation, oxidation rate is independent of thickness of silicon dioxide layer as well as temperature. Okay, in case of wet oxidation, the oxidation rate gets slower down as the oxide grows. So the right option for this question is A. Oxidation rate is independent of current oxide thickness and temperature. Thank you.